We're here at the IASIS Tennis Dome, where the score is 5-2, with five games for Lorenzo of the Manila Bearcats versus the ISKO player, who will find out his name momentarily. The ISKO player is Giorgio Rossetti. Lorenzo, the fan favorite, as he has his hometown audience behind him. Looks like we have about 2,000 students packing the tennis dome, all kept cool by the four spinning fans, 6 meters in diameter, powered by helicopter motors. Keeping us all cool. Although it is actually a delightful time of the year to be in Manila, being that it is January, February now, Groundhog's Day actually in the US. Lorenzo nearly flying into the fence. Lorenzo making a rare unforced error. Giorgio of ISKO looking to capitalize. Lorenzo approaches the net. Well done by Lorenzo. Receives a round of applause from the rabid audience. Lorenzo frequently returning to his towel. Also just to receive encouragement from the thousands of fans being pushed up against the fencing. That's the only thing separating them from running onto the court, and sheer chaos ensuing. Point Giorgio. Earning applause from the small but potent ISKL fan contingent. This is the first matchup of the day for the ISM boys versus the ISKL boys. That game just went the way of Lorenzo of the Bearcats. Right now the scoreboard says 5-2, but they'll probably adjust that. I would assume it goes up to 6-2 for the Bearcats. The first player to win 8 games is victorious. Once there is an 8-game limit reached, the mascots of the winning team are released onto the court to do a quick run around. In the case of Bearcats, it would be a Bearcat romp. Bearcat boys are doing quite well, so we have seen several Bearcat romps in the last 36 hours. Lorenzo is playing especially well, looking very relaxed on the court, very stylish in his coordinated shoes and socks. Lorenzo is a junior for ISM. This is certainly not his first rodeo or IASIS. Well-known fact is that rodeo is not a sport within the IASIS contingent of possibilities. This would probably be Lorenzo's second or third IASIS. If any of our many listeners can get back to us on that, we'll let you know on the air. Lorenzo going for a water break. Giorgio going for a water break. Looks like that will take it to, I want to say 7-2. Lorenzo's way. Bearcat boys are looking to achieve gold once again. They've had an amazing run over the last few years. ISM girls looking to return to the glory days and looking for a gold medal this year. Now we've got the scoreboard adjusted. Lorenzo is up 7-2. Looking to achieve that eighth win. So to the fans' delight, they would love to see the double canister of Bearcats released so that the total six-pack of Bearcats can run briefly around the court for the Bearcat romp. Well played by Giorgio. Still fighting despite being down 7-2. Trying to get himself back into the match. Just wide on Giorgio's forehand.
Don't let him be, don't let him be.
fault on the first service. We'll do it again. Miss hit on the return by Lorenzo. Giorgio needs to win this game to stay in it. Bearcat fans hungry for a win. The Bearcat mascots are anxious to be let out of their canisters. This could be an easy put away for Lorenzo. No chance of returning that one. Lorenzo is victorious, winning 8-2. I'm not sure if you can see this on your televisions, but right now the six Bearcats are being released from their canisters. They're running like crazy around the courts, jumping over the net, which is about as high as a Bearcat could possibly jump. There's actually a small stepping stool out, allowing them to get over and back and forth across the net. It's a frenzy. In order to get them off the court for the next match, they'll actually have to lure them back into their cages. Fortunately, as you would imagine, they have a delicious treat of Potato Corner to lure them back in. Our sponsor, available for you down on the first floor across from the Bearcat Cafe. I sure would love some delicious empty calories right now. Get on down to Potato Corner. That was the first match of ISM versus ISKL, and so ISM now has a 1-0 lead. They'll need to win the best of five. And we'll see if we can move over to another match and keep you updated.